everybody. Yay! We're going to do this again because now I'm on camera. So I've got a crazy testimony for you guys.
Yes, you do.
So this happened on Thursday, which if you don't know was our house's prayer night that we were joining in. The 30 days of prayer, and we had like a little slot last Thursday. I unfortunately wasn't able to attend because I had to work. When I got home from work, my friend and I went and just adventuring. We decided to go climb the butte because it was just beautiful that night. We ended up meeting a woman called Chandler and just tried to talk to her, tried to get some of her story. She ended up wandering away, and we were kind of like, okay, well, that's fine. And Holy Spirit prompted my friend to go find her again, and I was like, sweet, let's do it. So we walked all around the butte. We ended up finding her. We just started talking Jesus to her, and she started talking Jesus back to us. And so we were kind of doing this whole back and forth, like, what's your story? She knows the Lord. She grew up in a military family where her dad was like the chaplain of like a sick military or something like this. A little bit hazy of a story, but it was great. So all of a sudden, I just feel super prompted. I'm like, it's time. Like, it's time to bring it into the, like, do you want Jesus time? And so I just looked at her, and I was like, Chandler, I don't want this to sound weird to you, but I feel like there's an invitation for you to rededicate your life to Jesus. And she kind of looked at me, and she was like, I'm not feeling it. And I was like, all right, give me 5 minutes. Like, you just wait. We'll get there. So we just continued to pray for her, asked if we could pray for her. We were praying for her. And then I felt like I was supposed to sing over her. And so I felt like I was supposed to sing You Know Me by Stephanie Gretzinger. I'm sure a lot of you know that song. So I started to sing it over her with my hand on her heart. And her eyes got really big, and she grabbed my hand, and she's like, I'm ready. I'm ready. So she drops to her knees with her elbows like in her car door and just starts like, Jesus, I need you. I'm sorry. I need you. I can't do this without you. I need you. Blah, blah, blah. Just totally rededicating her life. And we're like,
it worked.
And then we're like, well, you know, it says saved, healed, and delivered. So like we're step one. So maybe like next two steps. So my friend turns to her and says, Chandler, do you know what it is to be baptized in the Spirit? And she was like, yeah, but I don't see any water. And we were like, oh, let me tell you. And so I explained to her in gist what the idea of being baptized in the Spirit was. And I said, is that something that you would want? She was like, yeah, I think so. And I was like, okay. So we just start going after it and just praying and just asking her to repeat after us, like, Holy Spirit, come. She starts to shake it, giving a good Holy Spirit shake away. And then all of a sudden, I look at my friend Danielle, who was with me at the time, and I just kind of gave her the nod because I knew she had something to say. So I was like, all right, Danielle, say it. And she goes, all right, Chandler, the gift of tongues is coming over you right now. And I was like, okay, we're doing it. We're going for it. And so Danielle was just like, all right, open your mouth, and whatever comes out. She instantly starts speaking in tongues. And it was so cool. And then the cops came up, and we're like, we're closing the gate. So we had to, like, shut it down a little bit.
Yes, and but they wanted to get saved.
We thought about it, but it was just, we were kind of still in, like,
so great.
Like this mode. So yeah, so.
So great.
Woo! Wow. Do it again, God. Amen.
Yes.
Wow.
Yes. Great testimony.
That is.
Thank you, Bridget. Anybody else? Oh yeah, after that one, Marianne. It's good practice.
Okay.
I think it's good practice.
All right. My testimony is that God, in the last year and a half, I was really sick when I came back from Wilsonville, really sick. And And when I got back here, God, like, it's almost like my whole life of everything in like a year and a half, God really did the full solidification of the mind, body, soul, you know, thing. And it was changing my whole belief systems, and it was getting everything back into right standing with his beliefs and getting rid of religion. And you guys have been a major part in that, and I want to just thank you again.
You're welcome.
You guys, huge. The people people that you brought in and the refreshing and the renewal and the things, I'm alive today because you guys are here.
Wow.
It's true.
Yeah. Awesome.
And so I just am thanking the Lord because I ended up, you know, like I shared a testimony about how I went in and I had a mammogram and they said it was irregular. I went back in. That was fine. They're like, you're great. It looks even better than you've ever seen it. You're normal. We'll have regular checkups for you. And then I had some pre-cancer issues going on and feminine issues. And so I was dealing with that. And they actually took a biopsy, and there was some irregular stuff going on. And then I was like, no. We know, like, with Steve and Wendy Backlin, with you guys, with... you know, Bethel, Bill Johnson was talking about it. I was like, no, I'm not taking this. I'm not going to have one more procedure done. I'm done. I'm done with it. And I was like, God, you are a big God. I went, sat in his lap, spent time with him, got into the word, and I started declaring his truth. That by his stripes, we were healed. He did it at the cross. It was taken care of. I started declaring it, claiming his compassion and his goodness. It was funny. It's right at that time I had another friend that she gave me a 3-CD series about that and about shifting your beliefs on top of everyone else that you had had. And I'm like, okay, I get this now. And so I believed it, and I actually had an encounter where angels and the Lord showed up, and I got healed. And I went back in. They did the check. They did the full thing, and they're like, we need you to come back in today. I was like, what? I was ready to cry. I'm like, no, I'm well. I'm healed. And they're like, no, we need you to come back in. And I was like, I said, go check on that because I think it's a normal thing. And she went and checked on it, called me about 15 minutes later, and I was like, oh, yeah, we thought you wanted to come in. I'm like, no, I'm done with doctors. And she's like, it's normal, it's fine, we'll see you in a year. Woo-hoo. So,
that is so good. I really believe, and I think actually the medical community believes also that a major part of illness that people go through is soul related.
That's right. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
I mean, I would say as high as 80%, 90%.
Yeah.
And it's crazy. I can't tell you how many times I've prayed with people that like had fibromyalgia or something like that. And we just remember out sisters that time. We prayed with a gal out there, prayed for like 45 minutes, taking her through kind of like an inner healing thing without praying for the fibromyalgia thing. We stopped and said, so how's your body feel? She goes, oh, I don't have any pain in my body anymore. We hadn't even prayed for her body. It was soul issues. So, yeah, great testimony. Woo-hoo! Well, we got room to dance and roll in the aisles and everything tonight. This is exciting. Woo-hoo! We can get wild. We can throw chairs in the air. We can do whatever we want. Anybody ready to... What, is there another testimony? Debbie, we haven't heard from you.
I know. Actually, the Lord gave me such a huge download, but it's too much, and I'm going to save it till I tweak it. It's going to be powerful. So just know there's something coming.
Yeah. Something coming.
I don't know what it is.
There's lots of things coming. So... we're going to, after worship, we'll, hopefully the team that went with us will be here. It's like, they're not here. How are we going to share? Just to share about Pedro. And it was just really off the hook. It was so good.
Wow.
So good. So we'll share a bit about that, and then we'll see where we can go from there. But I know we're going to have a good night, so... anybody want to have a good night?
Yeah.
You know, any night in the presence of the Father is a good night. Why don't you stand up? Sandy's going to take us.
Maxine. Oh, you too. Man, I was sick.
Is that your coffee? Yeah. Okay, let's pray. Father, we thank you so much that you invade our lives. You do so much, so many cool things. And just thank you for an opportunity to share here your goodness, kindness, and amazingness. And thank you for an opportunity to worship you. I pray that our praise and worship would just so bless your heart tonight, that you would fill this anointed house with angels and your presence, your goodness, and your glory. We love you so much. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you. Have your way. Holy, holy is He. We lavish our love on you tonight, Lord. We lavish you with it. And we receive your lavish love.
Yes. Yes.
Oh, how I love you. Yours. All I need.
Smiling on us, looking down upon us in this place. Thank you for what you've called us to. And I pray tonight, Father, that we have fun. That we have fun, that the joy of the Lord would fill this place. And Lord, this would be like this place would be like a playground. That there would be all these fun things that we get to do with you. Like Disneyland. And except for not the pretend part.
Yeah, that's right.
Like Disneyland, but the real deal.
That's right.
Yeah, yeah, it's not make believe. And it wouldn't be the magic kingdom, but the power kingdom.
Yes.
Experience heaven kingdom.
Yes.
Father, we thank you for what we've experienced. We thank you for what we've been able to be a part of. But we say a simple prayer, more.
Yes.
We want everything.
Everything
that has ever been written in the scrolls in heaven about our lives, we want to see fulfilled.
Yes.
We don't want to miss any of it. Even notes that are in the margin. We love you, Father. We thank you that you are an extravagant, amazing God and Father. In Jesus' name. Amen. Can we thank Sandy? Trying to get a hold of what I felt like the Lord was showing me during worship, that I just felt like there was a grace tonight for people that are facing whatever it is in life where maybe you've taken the step of, that I know this is possible with God. And I feel like He wants to shift that to probable. That for some of us that are hoping that it goes to just a new level. That it's not just hope. I mean, hope is good. Hope is important and we need hope. But that it would go beyond hope to this is going to happen.
Yes.
And how do you want to do that, Pops? Just stand up if you want to see a shift. And while you're standing up, I'll try and figure out what we're going to do. Yeah, Marianne.
Just to tailspin off of that, what I was seeing was I saw Jesus like show up in the room, and I saw him like with bags of gold, and he was handing each one of us like bags of gold, each one of us, that we all had it. Not one was left without the glory of God and without the gold of God. And then when he handed it to us, he was like, this is your commission, this is your Isaiah 61 commission, that you go and you receive what he has and declare it over yourself and believe it for yourself, and then out of that abundance that it's going to flow out from you, and that you're going to give it to the others out of that glory that he's giving you. So I feel like when you had everyone stand up, that's part of it.
Yeah, and as you were talking, I heard the Lord, I felt like the Lord said it's time to shake off the old mindsets, the old thoughts, the old attitudes, the old way of thinking about what you're stepping into in the future, so that there's room for the new. Because what I was sensing goes right along with what Marianne was sensing as well, that this is just, everything's brand new. So shake it off! Shake it off, shake off the old. And Father, we make room for the new season. The new season that says everything is possible and all the good stuff is probable. And this is the season where we step into abundant life. And the thief has no hold on us. The thief is not going to kill, steal, or destroy. He has no hold in Jesus' name. And Lord, I just plead the blood of Jesus over our spiritual eyes, that we would just see what heaven is saying. Yes, in Jesus' name. Amen. Woo! That's good stuff. Thank you, Lord.
It's an honor.
Yeah,
Brian, sure. Can I get in with that?
Sure.
I really felt with that. We too often look to God towards His hands and working with Him. But I really felt Jesus saying, It is not, I am not a God that does anything. I am a God who is everything. I do not do, I am.
Amen.
He's simply, I am.
Amen.
And it's looking to God to do something. He says, I don't do, I am.
Amen. Stepping into Him.
And this goes real along with what you guys were saying. While we were worshiping, I felt the Lord's deep love and grace over all of us. As He was saying how much He loves it when we sing in the Spirit, when we pray in the Spirit. But I saw that it actually is unlocking things, and that He has new things He wants to show us that He has kept until this time. New secrets, new things that we haven't known before. And I also saw this really weird lock. It almost looked like a puzzle, but it's being unlocked, and we're going to go into new places that haven't been available until now.
Yes.
Oh,
yeah.
Wow.
Woo! That's so good. Yes.
Sorry.
It's okay. That's okay. That's it. Is it from the Lord?
It is.
It's good then.
No, just when you were praying that and new seasons and shaking everything off, and this came to me while we were worshiping. Excuse me. Is, you know, when we make our declarations, sometimes we have to shift what we're declaring. And I learned this from a couple different people, but Carolyn Leaf, that teaches about brain and how our body, okay. So we can make a declaration, I am debt free. And that is a great declaration. But our brain only hears debt. It's processed in
so
the
good.
Negative. It doesn't process debt-free, it processes debt. Or you can say, nothing is impossible.
And it processes impossible.
Nothing and impossible. But it's like impossible. And so all things are possible. I am financially free. I am wealthy. I am prosperous. So I just, because we were shaking the old things off, I just felt it was timely to say, just be careful of what you're actually declaring, because our brains don't remember the lets, the does, the little adverbs and things. It'll just focus on those really heavy words, and then subconsciously, that's what your brain is thinking.
Wow.
All right.
We are wealthy, very wealthy, extremely wealthy, over the top, in great health.
Yes.
I am in great health.
Yes.
My wife went to the doctor today, and she said, you're in great health.
Yeah.
Woohoo!
Amen.
All right. Alyssa, you got something for me? Or for us? Maybe I should move this out of the way. Can I hold that for you?
So at the bottom is a scripture, and it says, let the children come to me, and do not forbid them, for of such is the kingdom of heaven. And just to like remind you that there's nothing that's going to stop you from going to the Lord.
Amen. That scripture is about childlike faith, isn't it? Yeah. Who in here you feel like, I could use a little childlike faith? Ah, there it is. Boom. I bless you. I bless you with stepping into a season of childlike faith like you've never seen before. And that you would actually look in the mirror and go, did I really say that?
Can I say something about this really quick? I know there's time is of the essence.
Can I borrow that?
I know time is of the essence, but
God's outside of time, right?
That's right.
This is Matthew 19:14, one of my favorite scriptures. Back when I was in Uganda, the Lord told me that I would have a ministry with orphans. And this was the scripture that came to my mind. It's been my life scripture since then. And all of a sudden, it's like everything stopped. It's like, did I really hear the Lord? Did I really hear that? And then all of a sudden, the Lord provided so I could go to Zimbabwe. And I felt like there's been this reawakening of what He promised me. And then for you to have Matthew 19:14, that has been my life verse since He made that promise to me.
And what does it say?
It's what I've called my
ministry. Does it say come?
Let the little children come.
No, just the top. Come.
Yeah. Come. So it's like a confirmation to me that it's time. So thank you so much.
Good job, Lisa.
So I'm not exactly sure what this one means. But all I know is whoever wants this, this is you, the beautiful you.
Multi-dimensional, multi-colored, beautiful you. I bless you with that.
Yeah. Ron, can I say something to my kid? I am so proud of you for one really big reason. You did, it makes me cry. You didn't know what that one meant. You didn't hear from God, and you didn't make something up. You just said, I don't know what this is, but the Lord says it's you, and that's like a really big thing in the prophetic, to not just make something up, but to really hear. God didn't give you anything, so you didn't say anything, so I'm really proud of you for that.
Yay!
And this was a confirmation for me, so thank you.
You have a word for me?
While you were praying, I saw like God looking down at us, and he like grabbed the building almost, and he kind of turned it sideways, and he like dumped out all the negatives and put it in.